warning. This video may be experienced as blasphemous. Just so you know.
This is just a little video about this guy. You don't recognize him? Alright, let's take a more familiar picture. This guy. That's right, Jesus. And why I think he should more look like this guy, Obelix. When Jesus was killed on the cross, they got him down from it and buried him in a cave. A cave with a huge stone in front of the entrance. But when they got back to visit his grave, the stone was set aside. There was no man who had the power to move stones of that size, except for Obelix. Right, so there you are lying in a cave, when all of a sudden you wake up again in a hot and sweaty cave. You must be thirsty, so what to do? Well, he was sweating, of course, at least of the fact he realized he wasn't dead. He could have turned into a zombie. Well, that would make everybody nervous. But to quench his thirst, he could, of course, turn his own sweat into wine. The problem with wine is it contains alcohol and sugar, which would make you fat. And who is fat too? Obelix. And Jesus is always pictured as a guy with long hair. For those who have long hair, we all know it feels pretty nasty to have sweaty hair sticking in the back of your neck. So the best thing you could do is put it in a tail. Or two tails. Just like, you guessed it. And finally, one would not expect Jesus to have very warm feelings for the Romans, despite of how much he claims to love your enemies. And who's not a big fan of the Romans too? Right. Oh, and one more thing. I really don't understand why anybody would kill Jesus instead of that Barabbas guy. I mean, Jesus could turn water into wine. They just should have given him a bucket of water and say, "You work for us now. Try a good scotch next time." It's just such a waste.